I'm Brent Seals in the College of Engineering, and I focus on the digital imaging of antiquities at the University of Kentucky. As a graduate student, I was fascinated with computing and what could be done with computing. For me, it was a completely blank slate in a world where a lot of things were already settled. So I think it was the unknown potential for how I could contribute. That was really what spurred me as a graduate student to go forward with research rather than stop at that point and take a job in industry. In the mid-90s, there was a huge push because of the internet's emergence for us to make libraries digital. And at the time, libraries meant things that were in books. I didn't want to spend time just imaging books. I wanted to move quickly toward things that were much more fragile, mysterious, unknown, located in the nooks and crannies of museums and libraries. So by the late 90s, I was working at the British Museum, the British Library, with some really interesting parts of their collection. A book is easy to digitize because all the pages are flat, but when you look at damaged material, nothing is easy. Everything is incredibly wrinkled, wrapped, damaged. We started to imagine that we might be able to take the most badly damaged things and completely unwrap them using only the imaging, not any kind of physical process. It was that problem where we settled and then started to discover that there were many really interesting things in that category. But I'll have to say, in terms of breakthroughs and research results, the moment that I received an email from Israel telling me that we had discovered a text in a scroll that was 1,500 years old, I received that result by email. That's a moment I don't think that I'll be able to replicate in my career. It was fantastic. I would say that we've shown through our framework that there is a pathway to take a completely unknown and damaged text and then to produce as a finding what it contains. The proof of that pipeline, which has taken a long time to kind of assemble, that's really the biggest contribution, because that represents sort of an engine for discovery. More and more I'm convinced that being able to produce and then deliver to the scholarly community that engine for discovery is probably going to be one of my biggest findings. The year at Google was fantastic because of the inspiration that comes from being around people who are swinging for the fence, to use the metaphor, taking a moonshot, are willing to think about trying to work on a problem that everyone else thinks might be impossible. So think about it. You know, I was at Google, a company that's known for amazing employees, taking risks, and I was in Paris, which is one of the most beautiful cities of the world and happens to be focused on antiquities. Those things together were a dynamic, dynamite combination. Having the students follow on in that inspiration has been a huge boost to what I've been able to do, because honestly, we can't really get much done in a university setting without having really talented students willing to work with us on our work. What I love about the University of Kentucky is the fact that it is a land-grant university that's connected with all of the disciplines that can make the diversity a powerful component in doing research. So there's an agricultural extension, there's a medical school, there's a great pharmacy program, but we also have all of the liberal arts with music and with design and with media and with communications and education. Computer science, of course, touches all of those things. So if you're a computer scientist, I think that being at the University of Kentucky is one of the most productive places you could be. With such a large number of opportunities at the University of Kentucky, there's space for a student to really discover who they are, what their talents are, and then to find the direction that they really need to be going while they're here. I think having that space is a key part of being at the University of Kentucky.